So today we are looking at Routine, which is a daily planner application which combines a calendar and tasks, as well as the ability to capture light notes. I'm going to see whether it's right for you and give you everything you need to know about making a decision on it. Now, Routine's evolved a lot since I last reviewed it. And since we last reviewed it, we've launched a brand new course called Learn Routine, or Routine Made Simple. You can find it below if you're looking to learn the ins and outs of Routine. And naturally, it's brought to you by Beth PKM. And we worked fantastically on a course with her about capacities. So you can find that linked in the description. Let's dive into Routine, and let's start with first pricing and availability. So Routine's a weird one because it's behind a waitlist at the moment. But if you want to skip the waitlist, you can join what they call the Believe plan. The Believe plan is $8, and that's billed annually, and $10 if you're billed monthly. And it's almost a donation at the moment because they haven't fully released their pricing plans. Set to be released probably next year, but an interesting lineup. Now, Routine is available on both desktop, Mac and Windows, that being, and iOS as well. And it also has a web version with an Android version coming soon. So now we've got all of the bits out of the way, let's dive into what Routine can do. And as I said, it's a combination between a sort of calendar and tasks. I call them daily planner apps. If you're in the hunt for these type of apps, we've got a list below that will help. But let's dive into this one. So this is what they call the agenda page. And basically, you can scroll through days here. And what's quite nice is you get to see a timeline-based view of your day. So I can move stuff around here, and I can move it quite accurately too. And you can see that it's moving around. And I have a meeting here as well. Now, I can add tasks here that can either be rescheduled or postponed. Talk about that in a bit. And you can see here that I've got 28 minutes left to this one. Now, whatever task you have in Routine, you can click into it and you can start making notes on it. And that includes meeting notes, which make it ideal for being able to collaborate on meeting notes. The other person won't see them, but of course, it's more for your structure, and it gives you a better opportunity to see it. If I go back, I can see that I can drag anything into my today area just by allocating it time. And of course, I've actually got this set up so that I don't work past 4:30, I believe. So that's probably why it's not offering me a hideous amount of time over here. But you can, for many people, this will be nice. It works particularly well on mobile. Now, you're probably wondering, how do I capture stuff? Well, there's an inbox, and you can see there's a wide variety of stuff in here. Now, there's actually a really amazing function, which I'll show you separately because it's a bit difficult to show you. I'm in a little bit of a portal view on my recording, but it allows you to do something called console capture, which is amazing. It's probably one of the best capture functions I've seen because it takes over the entire screen, shows you what meeting's next, what tasks you got, and it basically allows you to capture the task, event, or note, which is really nice. So these are all things that are in my inbox. I can go ahead and schedule them using natural language next Thursday, and I can even allocate for 30 minutes. So I can use some natural language here, and you can see that scuba diving in an underwater city is on my list. Now, you're probably wondering, okay, if I go to agenda, will that be there? And if I skip to the 14th, it's going to be here, and I have to go to the nativity, which should be fun. Not my nativity, my kid's nativity. So as you can see here, I can use command zero to actually zoom into things. You can do that with all of these areas. But let's show you the calendar view. Calendar views are really quite nice inside of this experience. So what you can do is you can add tasks up here, which associate to that week. This is a little bit strange. And then you can add tasks down here, which are sort of like inbox items, but not fully associated to the day just yet. So if I added something like review, then it's scheduled for today, but it's not scheduled with a time in mind. So if I go back to this area and I skip to today, you can see that it's scheduled to today, but not a specific time, if that makes sense. Whereas up here, these are basically postponed tasks for the week. So they haven't got specific times. So you can drag them into your sort of time area. And I accidentally rescheduled that one for last Monday. So it will... I actually dragged it into the wrong area. But you can see what I mean. You can basically drag these into your sort of schedule for the next couple of days. And they have all the ability to open them up. And you can see here, there's much deeper commands, which you can learn in the routine course, which is linked below. A nice little cheeky plug there. But you can also change to a weekday view. And this is actually something that's just been released in their latest version, only available for the Believe plan, I believe.
So you can see a week view and a month view, which is quite nice if you want a big zoom out of the month. And then I can see all of my tasks, unplanned ones, all pop in here. You can set up recurring tasks, and you can see any upcoming ones here. These are some of the dummy ones. I need a booster shot for hepatitis A, apparently, but it's a great segue to the notes function. So you can see this is attached to something called health. If I click into health, there's a notes area. It's really strange. It's not like a fully fledged notes app, but it's like half of a notes app. Because what it does allows you to create lists with tasks in them. So you technically use this for like a light way of managing projects. You can use this as things like writing a watch list, and you can make just, you can see what I mean here. You can use a slash command to do some of the basic stuff, like just basic text formatting. You can even embed stuff if you want to, but it ain't gonna really revolutionize your setup. But here is a good example of how you can use it for your tasks, because you can actually schedule these ones. So if I wanted to move this one to tomorrow, this underwater city, you can see that it moves right into the schedule. So notes are a great way, because you can go ahead and create them, and they've got some recommendations like travel destinations, and it can start populating it for you. But you get the concept quite a nice little way. And this approach associates to meetings as well. I think it was having a little bit of a load issue. I'm on a beta, I think, so it might be a little bit unfriendly sometimes to me. But it actually allows you to connect it to the meeting. Let's show you what a meeting looks like, just so you get a bit of context. And what's nice as well is if you have an open meeting that doesn't have anything in it, you can see that an agenda can be created, which means that you can naturally start working on the whole thing, or you can take private notes with summary and actions, etc. And you can join, you can see and actually attend a meeting as well here. So they do have plans to add more abilities as well as integrations, but I've connected my Google Calendar. They don't offer Outlook Calendar, but they do offer something called Workspace Directory, allowing me to connect my people to my account. So for example, if I wanted to create a specific task, I can actually associate somebody and almost create a profile on them. That's going to be covered in the course, but of course, that's something that you can do. You can set up shortcuts so that function I showed you earlier comes up. There's a new feature in the temporary setup called Journal, where you can actually sort of start journaling on events that were created, which is quite helpful. So that's, again, something that they're expanding. And as you can see, this is how you upgrade your pricing and plans. Now, other elements, there's ability to bring in your calendar, which is quite helpful. And you can also see that you can mock to dark mode and change some of the setups that you have here. They do have a Notion integration, but they do want to add more Zapier ones. I believe in their integration section, they actually mentioned the likes of Slack and Asana. So they're trying to, in a way, get under the belt of being more like AccuFlow and Sansama and be able to consolidate your tasks. So folks, that is the world of routine. Hopefully this gave you a good overview, and hopefully it gave you a little bit of a taster to what you can do with this application. I would probably recommend it because it's not a way that you can share with other people. It's a great personal planner application. It's on the pricier side, not as pricey as, say, AccuFlow at this current state and time, but at the same time, still pricier than what you get in some of like Todoist. But of course, it's much more sort of, at the moment, at least, it's got more abilities like calendar, notes, and the capture functions too. So hopefully you enjoyed this and it gave you an idea of routine. You can download routine below or learn it in the description. So I hope you find both of those useful, and I'll see you all very soon, I am sure. Make sure you like, subscribe, and I will help you out with any productivity apps. If you're in the hunt for any, go over to Toolfinder, and we'll teach you all about productivity apps there. Thank you, folks, and cheerio.